Welcome back. You attend's late news. Well, it was the online mega sale expected to change the mindset of Australian shoppers. But as the virtual doors for Click Frenzy opened at 7 o'clock tonight, the site immediately crashed. Thousands of people tried to access the sale, which promised discounts of up to 90% from participating stores, only to see a blank screen instead. Twitter went into meltdown as some pretty unhappy punters, unable to access the site, vented their frustration. Just typical, they plug Click Frenzy all week, and when it comes to the crunch, the server fails. Back to brick and mortar retail we go. Fail. Click Frenzy demonstrates that Australian retailers still think online is a new thing. That hasn't had the bugs ironed out yet. Another one, Click Frenzy promised they'd save me money. They were right, I haven't spent a single cent. And the company released a statement via its Facebook page apologising for the inconvenience and blamed some technical issues. So this disastrous attempt to enter the online retail sales world leaves Australia to play catch-up to the success of similar shopping events overseas. Now, Jeff Lack is a stylist at mensshop.com.au, and you've been involved in tonight's Click Frenzy, Jeff. Thank you for joining us. You must have been excited. It was billed as, you know, an opportunity for Australia to be involved in online shopping history. In the end, it's been an online shopping flop. Are you disappointed? Did it cost you, I suppose, some potential sales?
I think everyone was looking for a discount, really. So, you know, I think both consumers and retailers would be disappointed, no doubt.
What went wrong? Why weren't they prepared?
Look, you know, I guess overseas we've seen really successful versions of this, and I guess there's some things to iron out. And, you know, we'll see it back again for sure, because the fact that there was a meltdown means that there's so many people genuinely interested in online shopping and discounts like this. Mm.
Jeff, why has it taken Australian retailers so long to get online and to get on board in terms of something this massive when it comes to online shopping?
I was one of the sceptics, I guess. It's been, you know, quite a while that we've had online available. And, you know, I guess that people just weren't trusting online straight away. But certainly over the last couple of years, you know, the guys are getting on board. They're, you know, almost shopping as much as women now. And even after a couple of drinks on a Friday night, that's when we're seeing men hit us,
really?
Our site,
really?
And go shopping.
Yeah, but Jeff, what about things like a suit, for example? Now, I'm a bit old-fashioned. These guys are always ribbing me about it all the time. But I like to go in and I want to try it on. And you might walk past a shop, and we've all done it, and you think, that looks great. However, you try it on and it just doesn't feel right. You can't do that over the internet online, can you?
No, you can't, but if you know your sizes, you're going to have some success online. And the beauty of online is that you have access to, you know, retailers that perhaps aren't available in bricks and mortar as well. Mm. And we carry some amazing brands online that are offering really good prices at the moment.
Good answer.
And you are a specialist in the men's field too, Jeff, as well. There's got to be some appeal to the blokes out there who just despise the idea of going anywhere near a shop. And can you save themselves the headache and the pain and the stress of that by ordering online? Do you expect to see a growth in men's online sales in Australia?
The growth in men's is much greater than women's at the moment, so that's why we're getting so close to them being quite even. I mean, let's face it, if you could look at a video that told you about the product and how to style it, and you weren't being told some rubbish from a, you know, somebody else that doesn't necessarily care about you, you can choose what you take in, and then you can go ahead and purchase that, have it delivered to your home or your office in no time.
Mm.
Brilliant.
Do you think the future of the industry, though, does incorporate both? Do we need real-world shopping as well as online retail?
Well, I'm a shopaholic, so you'll never stop me shopping in stores. I'm still mad for bricks and mortar. But at the same time, I think a healthy balance of the two is the ideal.
Is worthwhile, yeah. Well, we shall see. There's a bit of evolution to go yet in the Australian online shopping sphere. Thanks for joining us, Jeff. You're going to hang around and join us for Bedtime Bites in just a little while.
Sure.
But Hermione's here now with a recap of our top stories.
Thanks, Matt.